everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Kat. So imagine a scenario. You are in an interview. It could be a job interview, consulting for example. It could be a school interview, grad school for example. So you did very well, dressed very properly, arrived in the office on time, started good small talks, thinking you're impressing the interviewers right now with your excellent resume and very fun talk so far. However, at this point, interviewer say, okay, so now how about you tell me once you led a team? And you were like, yeah, I have a great example for that in your head, thinking. Then you were like, oh, this story is very complicated. Where should I start? And you know, what is the best way to deliver this story? You started to mumble. You know, once I was in this consulting club and I was the president of this consulting club, and you know, we really did a lot of things. We hosted a panel discussion, we presented a lot of workshops, we even hosted a case competition. And then, you know, at the end of the day, I was really the best president ever in this club. What do you think about this story? And it's really not that great, right? So today I really want to use this video to tell you one key method that every single person in consulting use during their interview. This method is so good that I think everybody should know about it, no matter what interview they're in. Okay, so this method is called STAR method. It can either be a shorter version, STAR, STAR, or STARR, STAR. So STAR stands for situation, task, action, results, and additional R stands for reflection. So it sounds quite clear if I just spell it out for you, but let's work it through because you might make a mistake and confuse certain parts with each other. I think an example would be a great way to illustrate this. So let's just circle back to the question I started at the beginning of the video. If you're in an interview, right? The interviewer asks, tell me a story when you led a team, right? So let me tell you a story when I was the president of consulting club last year. But you don't stop there. You want to really tell the interviewer what was the situation, right? Because you don't just tell him or her a story about you being the president. You want to really tell him or her what you achieved through this whole event, right? So you want to use a specific example. So you said, I was the president of the consulting club last year, and we decided to launch our first local case competition in consulting. Okay, so that is specific what you're trying to do. Okay, and then you move on to the task, because case competition is very broad and every club does it differently, you know, in the United States. So you can say, so let me tell you a story about last year I was the president of consulting club and decided to move the in-person case competition to a digital case competition. That was the situation, right? So what did you do? And then you move on to the task. You don't stop right there. You don't say, oh, we just did this digital case competition. You can do it very differently. And what were the challenges and what were the specific tasks, okay? So instead of saying, you know, we did a Zoom meeting of 100 people, you say, but before moving to the digital case competition, we have three things to achieve, okay? So first, we have to recruit consultants to be our judges. Second, we need to find sponsors, okay? And third, we have to figure out a way to group the team and present it online, which will be very different from in person. So that's, let's say that were the three things that you have to do, okay? So action, what did you do? I led a team of 10 to achieve all these roles. Okay, then you basically in the action part, really detailed address how you achieve these three goals. First, we have a list of consultants within our network to reach out to. That was assigned to the VP of External Relations. Second, we have to figure out how can we find our sponsors, and that we reach out to the consulting companies, and that was assigned to another team members, and then blah blah, what did they do? And then the third, we have to find out technical solutions. What is the best way to use Zoom as a platform to conduct this case competition online? You know, that will be the technical team, blah blah blah. So you really wanna tell the interviewer how you assign the tasks specifically to each individual members. And then along the way, I have check-ins with each groups, you know, every 2 days, every 3 days, what kind of meetings that you did. And then you quantify the results, okay? So at the results part, you say, so for the external relation team, by the end of a week, we actually contacted 5 people and 3 agreed to be our judges. And same thing, quantification of the results apply to the other 2 branches or to the other 2 teams as well. You say, okay, so our technical team figure out the breakout rooms is the best way. Let's say we have 100 participants. We give the team a week to prepare all these logistics. So it depends on the length of your response. You have to assign time appropriately into the action part. And the final R is reflection. So some people can stop at the result part, but some people add a reflection, depends on the necessity of the interview. So most consulting interview would like you to say about some reflections, right? So you can say what you learned from this. So maybe you really learned what is the best way to lead a team is to really make a list and then give the task to each individual member really explicitly. And then maybe you also learned you should have end of day updates or end of 2 days updates, you know, like keep checking on them and real-time feedback. So different people have different reflections, right? Somebody probably learns the communication is really important among individuals. Also, it could be, you know, team meeting might not be the best way to talk to each individuals. That might not be the most efficient way. Everybody learns reflections from different perspective, so you should have your own reflections. But this is the general structure of how you should answer interview questions. So even with a different question, with the same STAR method, you can totally spin off the story to, you know, answer another question. For example, you use the previous story as the president of the consulting club, and you can totally spin off to answer the question of how do you solve a team conflict. And then maybe, you know, I'm sure there are some problems when you do anything. So for that case competition organization, maybe there's a conflict between your team members. Somebody was really busy and then he and she just couldn't do certain parts. And how did you resolve that situation? As long as you use the STAR method, it can be, you know, answered very clearly and concisely as well. Also, it really depends on the time of your interview. You can adjust how you tell the story using the STAR method. For example, it can be as long as, you know, 2-3 minutes. You detail described in each step what was the situation task and how did you take action and what was the result. But it also could be really short. And here I'm just giving you an example here. And you can see the situation was just one sentence. So in my previous sales role, I was put in charge of the transfer to an entirely new customer relationship management system on top of handling my daily sales calls and responsibilities. Okay, so that was the situation. You can see the tense there. And then the task, the goal was to have the migration to the new CRM database completed by the third quarter without letting any of my own sales numbers slip below my targets. The action. In order to do that, I had to be very careful about how I manage all my time. So I blocked off an hour each day on my calendar to dedicate solely to the CRM migration. During that time, I worked on transferring the data as well as cleaning out all contacts and uploading outdated information. doing this give me enough time to chip away at the project while still handling my normal tasks. As a result, the transfer was completed 2 weeks ahead of deadline, and I finished the quarter 10% ahead of my sales goal. So you see, this person really concisely explained the situation and tasks and detailed what did this person do to achieve that and quantify the results. And that's all you need, right? Like, that wasn't a 40 seconds a minute response. So it really depends on how you want to illustrate your story. As long as you use the STAR method, it can really arrange your story in a logical way and impress your interviewer. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you do, please like and subscribe to my channel so I can provide you more content about career development and grad school applications, PhD life. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video.